Well, it's Saturday, September 23rd, 2023, and I'm here in the Denver, Colorado area, having spent the night at a relative's house in Castle Rock, south of the city, and I am on my way to spend a couple of days in the Rocky Mountains. Some of the route will parallel the route of the California Zephyr train, so there should be some similar scenery. I've wanted to do this for quite a few years now, but a lot of places where the train goes, there aren't any roads nearby, or at least not ones that I could traverse at the speeds I would need to do the whole trip in a couple of days. So there will be deviations, but they should be almost all nicely scenic deviations. So I'm currently on the 470 bypass, whatever it's called. It's a freeway that goes around the southwest of the city, and then that'll hook up to I-70, which I will take west into the mountains and go through Glenwood Springs and continue on to Grand Mesa, which is where I will get some scenic overlooks, and then head north from there a couple hours drive and pick up another couple of highways that'll take me back east. It's going to take a good part of the day to do that first part, and then most of tomorrow will be in the Rocky Mountain National Park area. Junction to I-70 here, still on 470. Looks like it'll be a nice day for a mountain excursion. Traffic on this interstate than I would hope there would be this early in the morning, but what can you do? All right, on I-70 heading west into the Rockies. California Zephyr goes into the mountains. It's a little ways north of here. Film the entire crossing. I could do that, but I'm going to make it a little more abbreviated. This is the top of a fairly steep grade that goes all the way from where I got onto the interstate up till now. And most of the big trucks were laboring up it. I think this is the first time it's really dipped and gone downhill again, even briefly. pretty good downgrade here, 6% grade. Side of that hill is a road. I don't think it's our road, but it's a road. Up there, it's like up there is a road, and I suppose it's conceivable this could switch back its way up there, but I sort of doubt it. Seems like a lot of altitude to be gained in a short space. An express lane here, which is a toll road, but I'm not planning on taking that. Vicinity of the Idaho Springs, a historic district. That's just based on a sign alongside the road, but pretty sure this is Idaho Springs here. Yes, this is Idaho Springs that we're at. Now the express lane is that area between the yellow lines, and there's supposed to be a $250 fine for crossing the line. So I guess you're supposed to get in it, pay your toll, then stay in it. And nobody else is allowed to cut in and cheat. There on the side of the hill, and you can see all the refuse that they've dug out of there and just dumped down the side of the hill. There's a lot of stuff like that around here. Here. for Georgetown, so I guess that's what we're near there. Clusters of houses around here. Bakerville here. We got a some snow on the mountains up there. Lights here and the extra wide lanes along the side are for putting on chains on the tires. The signage say you have about 30 minutes allowed to put chains on there. Then there are flashing lights every so often saying you're car must have chains on it to proceed past the lights. So I'm glad I'm not coming through here in the winter because I have no chains. This is the exit for the Loveland Pass. Tunnel here presently. I suppose we're far enough up here where this might be the tunnel for the Continental Divide, but I'm not sure. It has a lot of the huge ventilation ducts on top, so I think it's probably a pretty long tunnel. The Eisenhower Edwin C. Johnson Memorial Tunnel. The tunnel I'm going through is actually the Eisenhower Tunnel from 1973. The Johnson Tunnel is from 1979. That's going the other direction. 5% grade coming out of the tunnel. Thing going up there straight ahead is a runaway truck ramp. Truckers, don't be fooled. 4 more miles of steep grades. Trucks' brakes start to overheat, they can pull over and let them cool off a bit. And if they can't, then they've got another runaway truck ramp here. Truckers, you are not down yet. 1 more mile of steep grade to go. Silverthorne. That's the town we're in here. Reservoir off to our left called Dillon Reservoir. I can't really get much in the picture while driving, but I'm hoping I'm catching some of it there. Really pretty area. I think we're technically in the town of Frisco. At least the sign said Frisco City Limits, I thought. I caught it out of the corner of my eye. Exit to get onto the main street in the town of Frisco. So I think we are in Frisco. can exit here to go over the Independence Pass. And coming up here is Copper Mountain and Leadville. From Vail, although not going through Vail, and about an hour's drive to Glenwood Springs. This place is absolutely crawling with, I don't know, they appear to be ski slopes, but I'm not sure they all are. Certainly some ski lifts. This is the Vail Pass summit that we're going over right now. about the steepest grade I've gone down so far on this crossing. I've got it in low gear to get a little engine braking. Even though it's an automatic, it'll do some of that. But it keeps trying to pick up speed, so I also have to use the brakes. Essentially at Vail now. There are three exits coming up for Vail, which suggests that the interstate goes through it or right adjacent to it. I had not checked that on the map. 45 degrees Fahrenheit outside here at the moment. And there's a golf course over there. Got to be kind of like downtown Vail around here. This particular town. I think it might be Avon. Yeah, I think so. Here. There's this little lake here, and there was a sign saying it's called Wilmore Lake. I wouldn't have expected something that small to have a name. Maybe they meant something else. I don't know. Anyway, this is a little rest stop here. Thoughtfully outfitted with several portalettes. is Eagle, the town of Eagle. Just went through the town of Gypsum a little while ago. We're coming into the vicinity of Dotsero, whatever it is. And this is where the Colorado River comes down and merges with, I don't know what it is, the American River or something. I forgot already. And that's also where the Amtrak, California Zephyr, comes down from the north and will then start paralleling the interstate. You can see on the GPS there the Colorado River coming in and joining the other river. And now it says, yep, here's the Colorado River coming in. And right around here somewhere is where the Amtrak tracks come down and will start paralleling us. I think they're right there on the left. You can kind of see the, Yeah, the tracks are just on the other side of the river there. 18 miles to Glenwood Springs, so we should be entering Glenwood Canyon any second here.